Royal Physician. I believe you and Corvo knew each other in former days. Unlike you, our friend Corvo knows what loyalty means.
Bah! I am loyal to my inner spirit. You are the one consorting with the most wanted man in the Empire.
It's my belief that Corvo was innocent in the death of the Empress, and the former Spymaster, or the Lord Regent, as he calls himself, is a ruthless tyrant bent on destroying this city, the heart of the Empire.
You are mistaken if you think there's love between me and our Lord Regent. But whatever you intend to do here, I assure you, I am beyond petty scare tactics.
If I don't scare you, Sokolov, perhaps these rats will. Even if they don't carry plague, I've heard of a swarm of rats stripping a child's body to the bone in half a minute. I've heard worse. How long do you think it'll be before you talk? Before you beg to talk?
Rats? Is that the company you keep now, Admiral?
It's the company you keep that interests us, Sokolov. We know you painted a portrait of the Lord Regent's mistress, the very aristocrat who is funding the military with her fortune. She is the key to the Lord Regent's control over the city, and we must have her name.
Sorry, Admiral. I cannot help you. You're part of this rabble, but I know you have your reasons.
Yes, he does. All we need is the name of the Lord Regent's mistress. It's very simple.
I elect not to tell you. You will have to force the words from me, and I warn you, my willpower is quite legendary.
Curious strategy.
Of which I approve. I could use a drink.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. The Ascendancy Circle has chosen Teague Martin to be High Overseer. Let us all praise their choice. The Dance of Investiture will take place without delay. The renovation of Caldwin's Bridge will be delayed indefinitely. Until then, citizens cross at their own risk.
I know it looks... I was inventing a new kind of lock. The tumblers, shaped like snowflakes. The truth is, there is no snowflake lock. I was just, you know, looking through the lock. Couldn't bear it if she knew. I know you're a man of honor, and I also know that you can kill me at any time. And for both of these reasons, I apologize and beg for your discretion. It's well known that Sokolov is virtually addicted to a rare liquor called King Street Brandy. The taste is revolting, but I happen to have a bottle. However, I am reluctant to give it to you for Sokolov. It cost me quite a lot. It is very expensive stuff, a blend of rare Pendician spices and a drop of whale oil. Would you care to purchase it? My Arc Pylon will eclipse the old Sokolov model. You require my unique services? We can quickly return to my shop.
Not the swill to be found. King Street Brandy? I didn't know any more existed. It is an extraordinary gift. I see I'm dealing with men of taste. I can tell you this much. She was always referred to as Lady Boyle. I painted her to be sure, but I never saw her face or learned her first name. You see, I painted her from behind. I assure you, she still makes a striking portrait. But I do not know which Boyle she is. I was to be introduced to her at a masked ball in her honor this very night. But I will miss that party, it seems.
A masked ball at the Boyle estate? Tonight? The timing is perfect, Corvo. But the Boyles are wealthy and ruthless, so security will be very tight.
Of course, you already have a mask, don't you, Corvo?
He's right. You will be able to mingle with them once you're on the ground. You'll have to find out which of the Boyle women is connected to the Lord Regent and take her out, in whatever way you can devise. We're very close now. If you do this tonight, we'll be able to strike at the Lord Regent himself and put Emily on the throne. May the wind favor you.
I hear you're off to the Boyles' little bash tonight. I have just a tiny favor I'd like to ask you. Could you give this note to Lord Shaw? You'll know him. A rather brusque man wearing a wolf's mask. In fact, he may be looking for me.
The Boyle costume ball, huh? Well, that'll be fun, but not for everybody. You ready? Regent's pulling out all the stops for the Boyle family. I didn't think there'd be tall boys patrolling here tonight. Watch yourself, Corvo. They don't fool around. The good news is, once you get to the party, that mask of yours will let you blend right in. Enjoy your evening out with the folk of quality. Better you than me.
Oh. body, Corvo. Is that what you dreamed of? All those months in Coldridge Prison while waiting for the executioner? Wealth, beautiful women in the latest fashions, laughing and drinking Tivian wine. And what of the host, Lady Boyle? I can see all her tomorrows, and I know that either she dies tonight at your hand, or she'll live out her days, month after month, year after year, far away, even as her fine clothes wear into tatters and her silken hair gets dull and gray. Half the city can see the lights from the party, and they dream of the delights inside. Will you tear it all to pieces? Either way, it's Lady Boyle's last party.
Don't chase after that. You don't know what's in those buildings.
No place is safe anymore. I don't understand what's happened to this city.
Another of their eccentric fancies.
Invitation, please.
No choice but to play.
It's going to be brilliant.
Going to be inexpressibly tiresome.
If you're not going to have fun, maybe you should go home.
I'll struggle.
Right this way,
once
sir.
Once we locate the wine.
Harold takes pride in being difficult.
As much as you take in being easy.
Shall we go in?
Emma insisted we meet her out by the curb.
Well, I'm going to catch plague and die waiting out here.
I'm sure she'd like that.
Why don't you wait here, as any gentleman would?
Look at that mask. Sick bastard.
Another party game. It was fun for a season, but now...
What is it tonight?
The party's indoors this time. Hello. The Boyles...
Careful. We tried for a peek upstairs, and the man on duty is an ass.
I should have taught him some manners. This party is a sham.
I'm sure he's just...
Did you hear about Mrs. Grimsby?
A party like this, anyone might
practice. What is it now? I thought her interests were confined to her family.
I think she ran out of family a while ago.
What's it all about? And how do you know this?
My servants heard it from hers, naturally. They were sexual rights, I can only assume. Or else...
Stop at once!
Hello.
Wall of Light is a gift from the Lord Regent, designed to keep his good friends safe. I doubt you qualify.
Good evening.
What most people don't remember is, the rats came a half a year before the Empress died, and the plague too.
Are you sure? That's not how I remember it.
If something caused this, it's not the Empress's passing. That's what they want you to think. Excuse me a moment.
You just stop that.
Yes. Pendleton? What's he got to say to me?
Pendleton is a gutless, lying sack of shit. I hope he's paying you well for this. Damn cold tonight. Hurry up, and let's see what you're made of.
Lord Pendleton's representative will select his weapon. A contest of honor will take place between this anonymous gentleman acting for the challenger, Lord Trevor Pendleton, and Lord Shaw, the challenged party. You will each turn and proceed to the marked positions and remain facing away from each other as I count down from three. You may then turn and fire
at will. Get on with it. I'll kill this fool, and we can all go back inside.
Sorry, my lord. We shall proceed. Stop! Stand right there. Three. Two. One. Clear the line! A promotion for the man who... Stop! Stand right there. Three. Two. One. Guards, to me!
Let's go. Witchcraft.
Feed your heart to the hounds. Promotion to the man who kills this one.
Now the rats can fight over your guts.
Stop. Stand right there. 3, 2, 1.
Clear.
Stop! Stand right there. 3, 2, 1.
Now the rats can fight over your guts.
Stop! Stand right there. 3, 2, 1.
And that's another patron dead. What do we do now?
It's lucky we're in demand. I hear the Estermonts pay top coin. No use trying them tonight. Let's see if we can find a little brandy. Let the Boyles clean up the mess.
Things are bad. Could the city get any worse?
Think you'll get your own squad after what happened last night?
Chances are very good.
This was once the house of a high overseer. The Boyle took special care to desecrate each and every room.
I say nothing against the Lord Regent. He's the only one holding this together. He'll make us great again.
Excuse me.
Welcome to my party. I don't believe I've had the pleasure. Anything you need, sir?
You? A gentleman?
I'll have you know I'm as gentle as I need to be in any given situation. As I think I've proven.
I told you not to bring that up.
There's a great deal I could offer you.
Don't be silly. The rumors say the Boyles practically own your estate.
What if I said I could get you out of the city, away from all this, to Sirkonos or further?
I don't believe you, but if you're telling the truth...
Bless you.
You there, stop that!
Hello again.
Excuse me.
Oh, leave him. Go ahead, help yourself. I take everything I can carry. They'll never miss it.
Hmm. I trust you are on the guest list, sir.
Evening, sir.
Really? I know it's a party, but I hoped for some privacy here.
No weapons at the party. Put it away, sir.
That's quite a mask. Are you on the guest list?
Are you trying to guess which one is which? I was thinking of sneaking upstairs to look for clues. Or would that be cheating?
Fight over your guts.
gather for whiskey and cigars tonight?
Chances are very good.
Yeah. They told me not to let anyone up here. Do me a favor and head back down.
Hope you enjoyed your evening, sir. But we'd best be on our way. Quickly. Pendleton said he would meet us here. I checked the wine cellar. Losing family gives a man a thirst.
Attention, Dunwall City.
You did it. And now we've done away with a woman, and a noble woman at that. But Boyle was a viper. She helped the Lord Regent kill the Empress. So I don't feel a thing for her.
Personally, I heard you upheld my name in a rather spectacular style and at some risk to yourself. I want to thank you for it. This little item has been helpful to my family over the generations. But I think you'll find more use for it than I ever will. Go on. Take it.
You've had a long night, Corvo, but I fear it's not over. Havelock and Martin have already cooked up something more for you. They would like to see you now, in Havelock's chambers above the bar.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. The streets adjacent to Boyle Manor remain.
Do you need me to build something for you? I can make anything. Practically.
Corvo, the time has come. Everything we have done, everything that you have done, has served to make this moment possible.
The Lord Regent is exposed, Corvo. Vulnerable. And now everything is in place to strike at him. We're one step from the throne.
One man, one beating heart, is all that's left of the forces that brought this city to the brink of ruin.
It is simple, but it will be far from easy. The Lord Regent's paranoia has reached an all-time high. He has lost the support of the Overseers, the Parliament, his financial base, and he's lost Sokolov, who made his security technology. So at Dunwall Tower, he has consolidated every remaining loyal man around him.
He knows something is coming. He knows you are coming. And everything depends on him being correct. Piero will help you prepare. Then Samuel will take you close to the tower, near the waterlock. Last time you were there was the horrible day that all of this started. Now you will go there and end it. Good luck, Corvo.
I'm not sure what else we could say, other than our hopes are riding on you.
Hello, love.
Ready to face the Lord Regent? About time we took care of Mysay. Long past time.